Hi there, my name is Lucy and I studied A-level PE alongside biology and psychology. I left Hills Road in 2019 and I'm now studying physiotherapy at the University of Birmingham. One of the main reasons I chose A-level PE was because of the variation within the course. So theories we learned in sports psychology, we also covered in A-level psychology, and similarly topics such as hormonal communication and the nervous system we also covered in A-level biology. Even within my degree now, already topics such as biomechanics and having that understanding of physiological processes within the body has helped with the transition from A-levels to degree level. Something else I really liked is that you could take part in almost any sport for the practical aspect of the course. So I chose skiing. So yeah, you don't need to be part of a team sport necessarily in order to be successful at the course. So as well as learning about the anatomy and physiology, one of the highlights for me was when we were able to bring all of our knowledge we'd learned so far together to create a training program for our coursework. And another highlight was definitely the trip to Boston. We had a day of work experience with the physiotherapists at Harvard University, which was really interesting and definitely helped my application to university. Another great thing about A-level PE is that because universities classify it as a science, it really does give you so many opportunities and options in terms of degree to do post A-level.
Hi there, my name's George and I studied A-level PE between 2011 and 2013. I then went on to Cardiff University to study medicine and an extra degree in emergency and pre-hospital care. I now work as a junior doctor in Bridgend, which is just west of Cardiff. So I studied biology, maths and PE. PE was by far my favourite A-level, of course, and it was fantastic in that we were able to study sport, which is one of the things that I love. The history of sport and the Olympics were two of my favourite modules. And also, kind of from a scientific point of view, understanding about metabolic processes like anaerobic and aerobic respiration, and having an appreciation for the anatomy of the human body, which was really, really useful going into medicine. I was involved in organising something called Copperdale Hills, which hopefully you'll hear about when you go to Hills Road. It's something that I still talk about at interviews today. So PE as a subject is fantastic for anyone looking to go into any kind of biomedical related degrees. I've got friends that work in occupational therapy, osteopathy, physiotherapy, physicians associates, research, biomedical sciences, sports science, just to name a few. So A-level PE is fantastic, great group of teachers and always a great group of students as well. I can't recommend it to anyone highly enough, so good luck and choose PE.
Thank you. Hi, my name's Kate and I studied at Hills Road from 2013 to 2015. I took PE, German and French A-level.
Hi there, my name's Lucy and I studied A-level PE alongside biology and psychology. I left Hills Road in 2019.
Hi, my name is Fran Steele and I went to Hills Road from 2013 until 2015. And then my A2 levels were in PE, biology and chemistry.
Hi guys, my name is George Paul and I studied PE last year at Hills Road alongside history and English literature.
Hi there, my name's George and I studied A-level PE between 2011 and 2013. So I studied biology, maths and PE.
Hiya, my name is Gemma. I studied PE, biology and Spanish for A-level at Hills Road.
I took a gap year during which I did a ski season in France and also worked at a leisure centre. I then went to university in the US for 4 years on a full scholarship for rowing. I went to Michigan State University and studied kinesiology.
I then went on to Cardiff University to study medicine and an extra degree in emergency and pre-hospital care. I now work as a junior doctor in Bridgend.
I'm now studying physiotherapy at the University of Birmingham.
I went to the University of Kent. I did my undergraduate in sport and exercise science there. Following on from there, I went to Loughborough University and I did my master's in sport and exercise nutrition.
I ended up getting a scholarship to Yale University and majoring in molecular biology this year, starting on the graduate entry medicine course at Cambridge University.
One of the main reasons I chose A-level PE was because of the variation within the course. So theories we learned in sports psychology, we also covered in A-level psychology, and similarly topics such as hormonal communication and the nervous system we also covered in A-level biology.
I chose PE originally because of the content, which I found really interesting anyway, as well as the relationship it had with my sport, which meant I could take the information I learned in the lessons straight out onto the pitch. This involved leadership styles, tactics, recovery methods, training principles and performance analysis, which all enhanced my career as a rugby player.
PE as a subject is fantastic for anyone looking to go into any kind of biomedical related degrees. I've got friends that work in occupational therapy, osteopathy, physiotherapy, physicians associates, research, biomedical sciences, sports science, just to name a few. So A-level PE is fantastic, great group of teachers and always a great group of students as well. I can't recommend it to anyone highly enough, so good luck and choose PE.
I really enjoyed the lockdown challenge because it helped me to keep up my fitness over lockdown, but I also thought that it was great because it was so good to see the netball team like develop such a strong bond. Like, we did lots of team calls. It was also great to see like how competitive all the girls were.
Some of the highlights were probably the meetings we had during it on Zoom and Teams, and also some of the really impressive feats we've managed. Some of our boys did some of the best wall sits, some of the best planks. We had some crazy cycling, and just overall it's really impressive that we can represent the school in that way.
The thing I have enjoyed most about the Hills Road Lockdown Challenge has been seeing the sheer talent of so many people that do sports at our college.
And I think that this was a really good idea overall. It gave us such a good feeling of, you know, team spirit and increased competition between all the sports teams, which is always a good idea, and I think it should be extended every year. And one new skill that I learned was how to do a front heel flip, which is something really cool I never thought I'd be able to do.
The past 4 weeks have been so much fun as we've been participating in the Sports Lockdown Challenge. The challenge has brought me to do activities every day that I wouldn't normally do, such as wall sits and planks, and it's also encouraged me to do challenges that I don't normally enjoy, such as cycling 10k every day. The challenge has also brought me to discover new teams that I didn't know existed, such as Corfball, Ultimate Frisbee, and the Hills cheerleading team.
My favourite part about the lockdown challenge is that it's brought me a lot closer to everyone else on the badminton team, and we've all really bonded trying to get the best scores we can. And we've been out and about all the time, cycling, running, whatever we can do to get the points that we need, and it's really exciting.
I really enjoyed the challenge, as did the boys. Great substitute for not being able to do sport over lockdown, obviously. Really helped keep the social side of the sport for us. We met via Teams every Sunday night to discuss our progress during the challenge, which I personally think was a really nice touch. On top of the lockdown challenge, I set myself my own personal challenge of raising money for MIND. I decided to do 5,691 press-ups, in memory of the 5,691 people that unfortunately committed suicide last year in the United Kingdom. And I have now raised just over £2,000, which I am so happy about. Hopefully that goes a long way.
Something I didn't expect, but we have managed to achieve with the lockdown challenge, is that being encouraged to have an online presence for Hills Corph has meant that we've been able to reach a global audience, which is very cool. And on a personal level, I've enjoyed having to push myself in running in a way that I haven't since primary, secondary school days across country. I think it's been really lovely to see all the college come together for a sporting event, seeing as the 5K didn't happen as it was supposed to happen. And I think all the captains have done a really good job of putting in the extra shifts and leading by example and getting everyone involved. And I just think that's really a testament to Hills, and I'm proud to have been a part of it.
I've had so much fun doing this challenge, and I know as a team we'd all like to say a massive thank you for all the hard work, effort and dedication that the sports department have put in to making this challenge run smoothly.
On the whole, thank you very much to Hills Road Sport. You've done an amazing job in the challenge. It certainly improved our lockdown, and I'm sure it has the other teams.
Welcome to Hills Road Sport. My name is Mr. Duffy and I'm Head of Sport at the College. The purpose of this video is to give you a brief overview of how college sport is organised, taking into consideration the competitive, club and enrichment component. The second part of the video will introduce you to the different staff within the sports department and their different roles. We're also going to bring you up to speed with current COVID restrictions that are taking place and how they impact you and your sport. We're going to introduce you to the minibus travel and the restrictions within that. Mr. Hansgate is going to introduce you to expectations of students and of staff during college sport and games. And then we're going to finish on Linda Swain introducing you to the different clothing lines that are available to students with regards to college sport. Congratulations on being selected for Hills Road Sport. Hills Road has a long history of sporting success. For example, the last 6 years running, Hills Road have won the prestigious Clifford Dixon Award, which is given to the top college in the east of England. Currently, we have 37 teams in 21 sports, and we follow three different components. We've got competitive sport, club sport, and enrichment sport.
My name is Kath Owen and I'm the Sports Department Coordinator here at Hills Road. You've already met Mr. Duffy, who is the Head of Sport here at the department. We also have two members of teaching staff, Mrs. Rogers and Mr. Hansgate. As well as the teaching staff, we have Linda Swain, the Sports Activator, Dan Tibbett, our Sports Administrator. The Sports Department are responsible for the running of the PE course while simultaneously delivering an extensive sport provision for the college, both off the field and on the field. As well as the staff in the sports department, we have a large array of coaches who you may have already met through trials. Here is an overview of the dedicated team we have here for sport.
With regards to all college sport, whether at competitive club or enrichment, COVID restrictions will have an impact on how these undertake. As a result, please can you all ensure that you read thoroughly through the risk assessment that's been put together by the sports departments. When arriving at your sports venue, whether it be the sports centre or up at Luard Road, please ensure that you sanitise your hands on entry and exit. When going into the sports centre, you need to have a face mask on at all times, until once you get into the sports. With regards to social distancing, when you're not playing sport, you need to make sure that you're socially distancing at all times. Guidance on individual sports can be found through the risk assessments. With regards to COVID constrictions, you'll have a face-to-face week and an online week. All training and matches will take place during the face-to-face week and may, where possible, take place during the online week as well. If you have any questions regarding COVID restrictions, please do not hesitate to get in touch with the sports department or contact me directly on aduffy@hillsroad.ac.uk.
When travelling by minibus, you might either meet the driver here in the car park or over at the sports centre. So usually we meet by the sports centre and then you're directed to the bus. Coming over to the bus, obviously students are going to be sat in this area. In these COVID times, unfortunately, all of you will have to be wearing a face mask for the duration of the journey. So as you're getting onto the bus, you need to make sure your hands are sanitised. There will be sanitizer by the bus, and you need to make sure you put your face mask on before entering the bus. Once you're on the bus, students are sitting in this area here. Please make sure you put on your seatbelt. Make sure that's done before we start driving so the driver doesn't have to remind you. If there's any kit to go on the bus, please do not leave it in this area here or down at the back where the emergency exits of the bus are. It needs to be stored above, either nice and safely, or in the front where unfortunately none of you students are permitted to sit during COVID restrictions with the driver. When we're in the bus, normal rules apply, so please make sure that you're speaking sensibly, no swearing, obviously no messing around, no taking your seatbelt off or getting up and moving around in the bus. And as much as possible, if you try and face forwards so that you're not transferring any germs to the person sat next to you. Obviously off the bus, make sure you haven't left anything on that you need for the fixture, and then on the way home you need to make sure that the bus is left clean and tidy. So please look under the seats, please look in all the spaces. There will be black bin bags on the bus, so please make sure you put any rubbish in the bus, and then the captain will help divvy up jobs to either take equipment back to the sports centre or to take the rubbish bags out and put them in the bin. Nobody just gets off the bus and that's it. You need to make sure the bus is left clean and tidy before you go.
Hi, my name is Mr. Hansgate. I'm a teacher of PE and obviously also taking lots of college sport. We want to go through a few expectations, and of course we want you to first of all have a fantastic time. We want to enjoy your experience, and I'm sure you will over 2 years. But with that enjoyment comes certain things we'd like you to consider. First of all, respect for obviously your coaches, your teachers, opposition, officials, yourself, and also behaviour, which is linked to that, of course. We expect high standards of behaviour where college sport, we expect you to uphold the values of the college at all times, both on the field of play and, of course, off the field of play at all times. Alongside that is fair play. We obviously play matches to be competitive and to win, but we also play with a massive degree of fair play. So we again respect opponents, officials, etc. You should consider your time at Hills Road and the college teams as a chance for personal development. So again, it's not only at all costs. Of course, we would like to win, but also we want you to develop as an athlete in whichever sport you are partaking in. Going with that, it's obviously you need to have a high attendance at your college sports. They are compulsory, they are part of your timetable, and of course, if you're trying to learn and develop, you need to attend. We ask you to be punctual. Obviously, these days, in terms of the COVID timetable, that's more tricky, but we do expect punctuality, and if you are there late, obviously that compromises the quality of the experience that we can give to everybody. And I guess I should finish again with well done, congratulations, and we hope you enjoy college sports.
Hello, my name's Linda Swain and I'm the sports activator at Hills Road as well as the netball coach. One of my duties is to organise the clothing for anyone that is a member of Hills Road. You can watch the following video and order through WisePay, and you'll get a reminder via email when this is available.